dear viewers that we are glad to bring to you the St. Emma Bulletin. It is important for you to know that St. Emma is a school of its kind in East Lands, offering a very unique curriculum relevant to the current societal needs. This transcends normal classwork, extracurricular activities that is not given priority to in the modern day academic. But before we go further, let's have the headlines. I'm your host, Sandra Njeri. Dandora Damset is a major security health threat. Health and sanitation not given priority amongst the poor population. St. Emma, an epitome of learning in East Lands. Emma Daycare, a daycare with a difference.
Aya tushome ini nini?
Children's dream in East Lands. Heart to heart run at Uhuru Garden today. And let's get the news in details. Dandora Dam site is a major security and health threat. What started as a plan to fill a quarry in Dandora has become a nightmare to the residents. Dorcas Hakini has more details.
I have been wondering why Mukuru, the so-called dump site, had to be in Dandora and not other estates. My question is the government aware of the dangers of the site? In brief, sources tell us that the dump site has done more harm in the health sector, security sector and education sector. People living around, both young and old, suffer respiratory diseases and diarrhea most frequently. The big heap of waste has become a hiding place for the thieves, who in return harass the innocent residents around here.
Some gangsters believed to have come all the way from phase 5 disagreed on how to share their money. This led to a shootout which left 5 Juhudi Academy pupils injured. It was later confirmed that one of the gangsters died in the process.
Hello, my name is Salima. What's your name, sir?
My name is Sula.
Who are you in this school?
I'm the deputy teacher in this school.
Actually, on Tuesday, which was 12th of May, what actually happened in this school?
No, there was some people. We had gunshot when we were within the school, but it happened outside the school. So when there are some people, you see, we talk about maybe there's some gang outside there. They were chasing one another. Then we found when the pupils were outside for games. Then it happens that accidentally some groups have sustained some injury from the gunshot.
How many pupils were injured?
So there were only 4 pupils who were injured on their feet.
Any people die apart from the
dumpster? No, not any people died. Only they sustained some injury on their foot.
Did you call the police?
Yeah, the police were called and they had the money to come.
Do you think about the government doing for security in schools?
I think the government should do more on the side of security. And making sure that every area where the pupils are learning are secure and safe.
Thank you, sir, for taking your time being with us for us in Tanzania. And may God bless
you. Schools are affected in that there is high rate of truancy since most pupils hang around with an interest of working here. Due to poverty that has drawn a line in most of the families, lack of jobs, death of the breadwinners, parents have no options but to risk their lives by working in this filthy environment. Waste bottles that are very dangerous are their day-to-day goods to deal with. No proper gadgets for protection, having lost their hope in getting a good employment.
I fear by 2050 the whole of Dandora might be a dump site if nothing is done. And so they say, Prevention is better than cure. Dorcas Awol, Emma News, Nairobi.
Health measures are not given a priority in Dandora. Residents go as far as eating near sewer lines. Veronica with more details.
As you can see, this sewer line is overflowing in the residential area, and the poor residents have to put up with the situation and go as fast as eating around this place. Food kiosks are almost around this place. The biggest question is, does the common Mwananchi care about his hygiene? Veronica Anjero reporting for St. Emma News.
St. Emma, an epitome of learning in East Lands. St. Emma is one of the hubs of education in East Lands. Pupils are equipped with relevant knowledge and skill, and not forgetting the life skill. Our various reporters with more details on gardening.
As you can see, our club members are reading and preparing for the harvest. After harvesting, we use these kumawikis in our food. Some we sell, then the money we get is used to buy our stationery, which supports us in our education.
More details on piano classes.
And there are different types of keys, but the key we are going to learn today is the key C. That's why I said first, you must hear the sound in the keyboard, like any music, any song must go in between the key I've shown you. Now, this is where we find the key C. After putting the keyboard on, and you have known that now the keyboard is on, you are going to where the volume is. You just raise the volume, you raise the volume. After raising the volume, you will come now and see the settings. Now, since you are much interested in the key C, this is where we find the key C. Like now, when you want to press, you start pressing twice.
More details on computer classes.
Start by learning the main part of the computer. The main part of the
computer.
Now, a computer has four main parts. And the first part is called the monitor. The second part is called the mouse. The third part is called... And the fourth part is called... And this is what we call... How do you call this one?
Keyboard.
Yes, this is called the keyboard. It's called what?
Keyboard.
This is a keyboard. Now, what about this one?
Monitor.
Yeah, this one that looks like a television is called monitor. It's called
monitor.
Now, after that, we have this one here. It looks like another animal. How do you call this one?
Mouse.
It's a mouse. Then lastly, we have this one, which is called the
CPU.
How do you call it?
CPU.
Let's go in dairy farming.
Here in St. Emma, we started a project of dairy farming. We are doing this project for getting milk. Some of the children of streets do not have milk in their home.
Yeah, as the pupil has already said, that we started this project so that we can help those pupils who are vulnerable. There are some pupils we collected from streets. So we started this project so that we can give them milk, and even the amount of money that we sell, we can use to buy books, pens, and even sanitary pads so that it can help them. So that's why we started majorly this project, so that we can generate money in order for them to have what they don't have.
Let's go carpentry.
We are going to learn how to split the timber into two. Okay? If you have the pencil, you take the timber, you draw a line. First you measure. Which size do you want to split into two? After measuring, you make a mark
make a straight line.
You should stand in a position whereby you are comfortable and the way you are holding the saw. Can you put your fingers this way? Your right finger. Right hand fingers. Yes. After putting them this way, this four goes inside the hole. See? This four goes inside. Hold it firm. Okay? After the four gone inside, then the thumb one raises here. You see? Or if you're not comfortable with that, this one thumb comes and comes here. And then this one comes out. It holds here. You see? Your knee should be here. And then this one hand holds here. Here. Can do the cut. See? That's how we do it.
Let's go tailoring.
Ikes. Na ingine naitwa bobbin. Naitwa bobbin. Unaingiza hapa. Hii ndio ukiwa na hii ndio inashona. Bila hii uwezi ukashona. Umenifika? Bila hii uwezi fanya nini? Uwezi shona.
Kando na masomo ya darasa, tunajifundisha kutengeneza bags. Hizi bags tukitengeneza zinatupatia pesa. Tunauzia wanafunzi wenzetu. Kingine tunauzia mama wa soko ya wanafanya biashara. Tena tunaviandalua. Tunaviuzia wenye wanafanya kazi kwa kahawa. Tena na hiyo tuna hizi beads tunatengeneza za mkono. Hata pia tunaiza, tunatengeneza. Tukiuza hiyo 20 naweza kutusaidia kununua tuka tissue na sabuni. Hizi bado pesa zinatusaidia kazi wasichana kauna sanitary pads na mashua. Tulifikiria kutumia hizi ngunia kwa sababu zinatoka kwa bei ya hizi. Moja inatoka shilingi 5, alafu inatoa mifuko 3. Ngunia ni plastiki, haiozi, tukitumia inahifadhi mazingira yetu.
Let's go cookery.
Oh no, we're ready.
So, thanks to Tema, we have a project known as the cookery. We do cooking every evening. And so that the following day we can sell to our teachers and some of the pupils, and so that the money we get we help to support the children who cannot afford the fees and the uniforms, and the rest of the money we help we use it in these projects.
More details on life skill.
Yes, today I want us to learn about child light. Now, who can tell me what's a child light? Can you try? Yes?
And it's the needs of a child so that he must survive.
Good. Child light is the need that a child needs for him or her to survive. Are we there?
Yes.
And it's supposed to be shared equally, whether you are a boy or a
girl.
Not a girl. Yes. Can you tell me those lights? Yes, that's
enough.
Light to shelter. You have a shelter. You must have a shelter where to live in. Yes. Light should be taken to hospital. That is health care. Light should be clothed. Good. Yes. Light to be educated. To be educated. Yes.
More details on art and craft.
So in art, we have various ways and various techniques of drawing. If, for example, you want to draw something, you can either draw it through what we call imagination, you can draw it by tracing, or you can draw it by just looking at that person direct. To draw a human being, there are some techniques that you are supposed to know.
For example, if I want to draw a human being, I'll simply draw some squares like this, small squares, so that I can know exactly how to draw that. So for example, if I want to draw a Rasta man, so I'll bring my piece of chalk, then I bring that way. So by so doing, I'll understand on how to draw that man, and then I know where the ear is, I can put the ear here, and I bring it down like that, then I put the hair, then you can see the portrait of this man is over.
Welcome to the St. Emma Art Club. We use these to make charts, and that why we use chart these sacks is because they are affordable and they are raised, and you can just make them and then sell to the nearby schools, sell to the willing parents, so that we can pay school fees and other requirements for the pupils not able to pay their school fees. As you can see here, we have other charts like the physical features in the environment, sounds and pictures.
Emma Daycare, a daycare with a difference.
Increasing demand for children upkeep, St. Emma Daycare has brought a new face to this industry. Let's get more details from the proprietor.
This is Emma's daycare, and it's run by Emma Claire. We are privileged to be working with Mrs. Kamau, the owner of St. Emma Schools. She has given us the opportunity to also have our children here. So we are dealing with children below 3 years. And then at the end of it, they go to her school, and that is how the relationship comes about. As you have seen, the children play.
Watermelon. Watermelon. Pineapple. Pineapple. Watermelon.
Sean Wapi got to learn, and they also enjoy themselves in the daycare.
Shema.
Of hope and evident that the future is guaranteed. Fatuma Abubakar has more details.
They try their best to achieve their goals, but as you know, in life there must be challenges. Mountains are there to climb and valleys are there to flow. The most problem they face is school dropouts. They leave school so as to search for their basic needs. This has shattered their dreams, and they think they have no future. As St. Emma Fraternity, they have risen and started a project of helping the children.
I was about 13 years when I lived with my mother. And my mother used to go hungry because my mother lacked money. And she also lacked money to pay school fee and rent. And it reached a time that my mother woke me up in the morning telling me to go to school. I ran away. I entered in the streets. I lived in Kuru, here in Dandora. Sometimes you could find me in Pangani, and sometimes you could find me in Isili begging for money and food. And sometimes when I was in Kuru, I used to pick plastics and irons to sell for food and for money. Then a woman picked me in the street, taking me to the nearby police station when they registered me and took me to Dandora Phase 2 children's home. I stayed there for 1 month, and then I heard about St. Emma. And then at that various night, I wrote a letter to the head teacher of the school. And when I wrote her a letter, in the morning I was here exactly at 6 before the head teacher. And when the head teacher came, it was on Monday. The head teacher read the head teacher read the letter to the school, and everyone cried in the school. And she gave me school requirements like books, pencil, and all requirements that I needed. And another teacher bought for me uniform. I school here from that time, and I have developed a sense of responsibility. I can speak fluent English, and I am healthy too because they have supported me very much. And I want to tell those one who are out there looking for school to come to St. Emma, because our head teacher is caring and she has a mother's heart.
Children in slums have very beautiful and good dreams. God has plans for prosperity and not disaster. Fatuma Abubakar, Emma TV, Nairobi.
Heart to Heart Run at Uhuru Garden today. Karen Hospital Foundation has organized a heart-to-heart run to fund patients with heart diseases.
And Heart-to-Heart Foundation, eh? Wapi ndio heart-to-heart? Yaani kila mkono, kila mtu hapa. Kupigia makofi hapo juu. Makofi hapo juu. Ya heart-to-heart. Na nuru juu yake. Nuru juu yake. Wapi ndio heart-to-heart?
Imara Primary, they're already here. Well done. Well done. St. Emma Academy are here.
Tema Student Support was started in 1991 by Mr. and Mrs. Kamau. Due to increase of number of orphans and vulnerable children in the surrounding, the school is located at Kitali Marigo slums. And when the school started, we had 15 pupils and 2 teachers. In 2002, we set our first attempt KCP, where pupils scored well. We had a mean score of 295.11. Last year, we did KCP. We had a mean score of 320.71. We have vulnerable children, and they do various activities apart from the academic, like home science club, where pupils are shown how to do cookery, sewing. Most of the extra activities we do, we try to sell some of the products, and the little money we get, or the money we get, we use it in school maybe for buying food, helping the girls who buy center girls, stationaries like chalks, exercise books, because we want to retain the vulnerable children in school. Like the computer classes, we don't have enough computers. We have about 2 sewing machines. At least we have 1, but we need about 5. The cookery class, the cookery club, we have a jiko, but we don't have ovens, because they we are planning, they can be even the baking cakes. So if we can have an oven, we can do better. To our well wishers, we request anything which can be provided towards the vulnerable children will be highly appreciated. Because here we are helping a Kenyan child, where we are trying to nurture their talents, nurture them, their academic, so that when they finish their school, or when they come out from school, they'll be able to help themselves.
Jerry, I wish you a blessed week.